And this also scheme removes the right to appeal. Do we really want to remove the right to appeal? Do we want to get some evidence? You're guilty or you're not guilty, and if you're guilty, tough, you can't appeal. You know, I think natural justice means there should be an appeal. So I wouldn't want to adopt this where it says you've got no appeal. I would want to say, okay, would an assessment panel be better running alongside or in place of? Can we get the timescales down to reasonable timescales? We need to include the right of appeal. And then if you take over, it says, again, it says, it will take no more than 6 months to complete the investigations. Will take no more than 6 months when the decision to investigate is taken. Well, if the decision to investigate is not taken for a month, and then you say you've got 6 months, there's 7 months, and then it's going to come back to a panel who's going to be there. The time scales is just going on. So I would like that 6 months to be condensed to 3 months, so an investigation takes 3 months. And that's actually particularly complex.
Yeah, can I interrupt you? Because what you're doing there is you're writing our new process.
No, I'm not.
I know you highlight, but I think what we need to do is we need to go away. We need to come back with another policy that's easy, that's, as you say, bespoke to the rural, that covers all them points. We can have the discussion on the new one. Whether there's an appeal in that or not, we can have a discussion when we have a look at the new policy to see how clear it is. And I think that's the best way forward, because obviously what we've got is ancient and it's not working. There's two new ones there, some of it we like, some of it we don't. I think if Vicky can go away, sorry Vicky, and bring us back in, 2 months after Christmas? How's after Christmas? With a suggestion, send it out obviously before the meeting, and then we can come down and sit down and have a look at it and see what we think. Phil wants to come in, so that's it. Phil, I'll bring you in.
The simplest approach I have in my mind is merely to take Wirral's process, ancient or not, and put in the informal panel somewhere after the pre-assessment reports and inquiries that are covered in section 7 of ours, somewhere between section 3 and 4, because our process needs to take account of the views of the independent person, and the panel that's been suggested in one of the other councils also requires some input from the independent person. So I don't see why we can't simply slot this informal pre-hearing, a formal pre-hearing process into ours and see how it works.
Thanks, Jay. Just to say, this was actually August 2014. It's not ancient. But it obviously does need some updating. I'm happy generally with the protocol that we've got, and I think it does just need small changes. The adding in of the subcommittee or whatever, and any exceptions, as Angela said, to come back to the chair and to this meeting if there are exceptions.
What do you feel about the right of appeal?
Well, it seems unfair not to have a right to appeal, really, although I do understand what Phil's saying around if previously, I mean, as far as I know, a lot of the conclusions that these investigations come to is just to apologise to another member. And if something as trivial as that, an appeal seems a bit silly. If you have to spend time again then, and who would you appeal to? I think that's the other issue.
Well, we have an appeals panel. There's an appeals committee that hears the complaint. And then if they complain that the subject member's unhappy with the outcome, they can appeal to another committee, appeals committee, which is made up of one member of each party. So there is that process where there's not a lot of people do appeal, as far as I can remember, although some do. Do we want to give that right of appeal for those, you know, people appeal that
have that discussion at the next meeting. I wanted to contribute.
I'm just going to be a bit lighter actually, so I was going to let Brian go first. It looked like he had something pressing. I was going to say, I think the committee idea, I think, is a great idea. I think the right of appeal, if it's something more serious, you're going to want to be able to actually have a say and actually try to meet the outcome. What I was going to say about the Lincoln Code of Conduct for the feminists amongst us, and surprised I never picked up on it, but I've spotted an issue straight away. It's a bit presumptuous. The monitoring office may, however, in his discretion, prefer complaints from the settlement where he feels the reasonable there. So perhaps it does need a tad tweaking here and there.
On your weakness.
Brian, do you
want to
come in?
Yeah, just on the point of the appeal, I think you suggested now we leave it to the next meeting. Yeah. Well, as I said, it was in principle, I agree with the right of appeal, because I think we don't have a right of appeal. Some people will argue that that is unfair. It may well be occasion where all it has to do is apologise, but there might be other occasions where there has to do something a bit more serious, and I think it would be wrong not to have that appeal in principle. But as you say, Chair, I'm happy to leave that to the next meeting.
What I'd like to say is if somebody brought that, in order to be fair as possible to everybody, complainants and subject members, that you know we come up with a scheme that from start to finish takes no longer than 6 months. I think if we come up with a scheme from the complaint is submitted on the 1st of January, it's concluded by the 30th of June, end of. Now, I realise not all cases will be like that, but the majority could. There might be some complex issues that might mean they can run on. But that could be brought back to the assessment panel in all cases during that time. But I think if we say to officers, you know, go away, try and come up with a timescale that allows us to deal with the vast majority of complaints within a 6 month timescale, and I think that would be acceptable.
Brian?
Yeah, on that point, I mean, I sympathise with what Councillor Blakeley is saying, but you can't always say that every single case will be done in 6 months. I think the way around it is perhaps to insert the word normally, something like that, to say normally it would be dealt with by a certain time. And if there were exceptional circumstances, if for whatever reason lots of people needed to be spoken to, or needed to take time to get more evidence, then it can go over the 6 months if necessary.
Yeah,
something like that.
Yes.
Members, thank you very much for that. I think with some things that Councillor Blake has just said about process and 0-6 target, unless there's exceptional reasons or other reasons why not. So I've heard all that. I think we can go away and ask you something. However, I'll be remiss if I didn't put the deadly words in front of you. Do you want to work in a group on this? So do you want to run with some members? Tune this over before we come back to the committee.
I would say at this point not, believe it or not. I don't say that lightly. Anybody can chip in if they want to, but I think because we've decided that we're going to work with the procedure that we've got and tweak the procedure that we've got, we've set down the parameters that we want within the procedure. So we know there's going to be the appeals that will be left in. We know about the 6 months. Wherever possible. We've set all the other parameters that we need. I think it would be time wasted to have another committee just to sit down. We'd be saying the same thing basically, wouldn't we? So I think if Vicky's happy with what we've said and you're happy with what we've said, to go away and tweak what we've got and come back after Christmas and sit down and have a look at the procedure. If there's anything that needs doing there, I think we can use that meeting to adopt it then, rather than have a meeting, to go back and have a meeting for somebody to say, well, I'm going away now. So it just seems sensible. Anybody who disagrees with me, please disagree with me. But I think that's a sensible way forward, yes, sir.
I'm not going to disagree with you. Brilliant to know. But as someone who's been involved in more of these activities than most people in this room, I hate to have to tell you, I don't see very much wrong with the protocol that we've got. The problem is human failings. It's not only within the staff. I mean, I've been toing and froing to this town hall.
months on one occasion when somebody's sailing around the world, they haven't replied to letters and that sort of thing. I mean, you know, it's human feelings. It's not this that's the main problem.
Do you know what? I think within the procedure as well, I think there has to be some sort of strengthening of that sort of something along the line. If you don't turn up to one meeting, then you're given another chance to turn up to a meeting. If you don't turn up to the meeting, then whatever the punishment is, it's imposed anyway.
Well, proceeding in absence. That's already in for
So there has to be a section within the protocol as well that says if people aren't playing ball, we proceed in their absence. Yeah, well, we need to enforce it.
Very quick one, too, very quick. Yeah, again, it's just on that, it's little to the time scale, and I think 6 months makes absolutely perfect sense. And the reason being, if someone's done something untoward and it's a task that needs to be taken to task and there's something to answer, 6 months makes perfect sense for the reason that you might not be there in 12 months' time. So you need to actually face some sort of realistic punishment if necessary. Whereby the group tracks on beyond 12 months, you might not be in there, you might not be elected, or other than the other way around. If there's a serious task, a serious case to answer, I wasn't thinking about anyone specifically, man, but if there's a serious case to answer, we could be re electing someone who is not fit for that role, so it needs to be within that sort of municipal year, almost if possible, but the 6 months sounds reasonable to me.
So
is everybody happy
for
where we are?
Yeah, I think
we're going
to
put that
result
in. Yeah,
yeah.
So does everybody understand what we're going to do now? Yeah,
yeah. Okay. Yeah. Just on the annexation, I just want to clarify the third recommendation where it talks about the revised procedure brought back to the 12 months. Is that 12 months from now? Or 12 months from now?
Then when we get the new procedure, it goes for 12 months and it's brought back. Just to make sure. That's how I understand.
Next year, we've got to get through it.
Well, we have.
And simply move a recommendation that the officers be tasked to go.
Do you want me to do it formally?
Yeah, well, yeah. Officers to be tasked to come up with any.
Can I just say that I think we should say as well that we are assured that you know, proceed.